Impress me.
And the winner is the British team.
Sorry, my friend, you're going home.
And the winning team is British team.
Good luck.
The American team has not shown up yet. Therefore, you have won.
Brian, please help Tiffany pack her bags.
The winner of today's mission is the British team.
Oh my God!
All right.
Who the hell is judging this?
Something's not right at all.
We're voting no one off.
Yeah. Have fun, Dr. Fahim.
The doctor thought it was such a close call. No one's going to get eliminated this week.
We are casting the Pakistani people.
We're auditioning the Indians, and we want to make a very strong team.
We're getting a less than expected turnout.
Lack respect for me.
I think Jeff lacks total leadership skills.
There is some conflict with Sean.
To be honest with you, I'm dead honest. I don't give a shit. I want to fucking win, and that's it.
Personally, I'm having a harder and harder time trusting certain persons on our team, particularly, I guess, Shawnee.
He's team leader by title, but he's not managing us.
That's a bit disappointing, actually. I would have expected more from him.
And the winner is the American team.
I think we're up against some really tough competition.
Hypothetically speaking, what's your exit strategy?
Hypothetically speaking, I will get back to you before this question and answer session is finished.
I want you to stand in front of US flag and send two of your teammates home. I am the bitch and I'm proud of it.
Three people have said that Moji is the weakest link. Why is Shawnee up for elimination?
Shawnee, I think, has checked out.
I just don't know how we lost.
How the hell are we supposed to know? We don't know. We haven't seen what the British did.
I don't know how many more missions or weeks I can go like this, and I feel like my spirit's breaking.
Yasmin, you haven't seen The Last of Us yet.
You think so? Which one of you is it going to be? Read it, Brian.
Yasmin.
I'm going home.
The best thing that my team can gain out of this effort today will be a better sense of having a team and working as a team.
USA!
We're one whole as Americans, no matter what has happened in the past.
And I can tell you, with this group of people, it's no easy task.
Hannah, we have to design a center for people with special needs.
I loved it. We got to go into classrooms and actually meet with the students here.
Try is not good enough for us. We have to finish it at 3 o'clock.
You did really well on Lost. There's something new.
You are not displaying the qualities that you would expect from
this
a leader.
Is a
which someone who demonstrates leadership qualities will win. Jeff, you have my best wishes.
Thank you.
So there's a broker who's got a client who's selling. There's another broker who's got a client who wants to buy. I'm in the middle.
So how is that going to help us win the task?
It won't.
The British team has sold one unit and one tower. Congratulations to the British team.
Watching Brian eliminated broke my heart. So I've decided that I should wish my team well and bow gracefully.
I'll see you at the hotel, Steve.
The doc voted for you, Matt.
Basically, we need to convert this area into a showroom.
I don't feel intimidated by the Americans anymore, and I feel that it's just a task for me and Steve to complete and succeed.
What's going to happen when it comes time for you and me to look at each other and say,
I'm going to laugh.
Why we have to stay and the other one has to go?
He thinks he needs me, but I don't think I need him.
And the winner is
America.
Yay, all right. There won't be a British team after this. I'm going to let you discover who it is that's going home.
Layla, I told you.
You should have left it then.
The only person I trust to do business with and work with is Richard.
I'll never be able to say a bad thing about Moshe. It's going to be my undoing.
I think of each person being sort of a separate country. And Richard sort of, without Richard, we may go to war.
I think it's probably true that in some ways I'm the glue.
I'm the crazy bitch, don't you know?
Moshe. I don't know where to begin. She's just such a good, valuable team member all the way around.
She is absolutely shameless when it comes to negotiating.
She's a good saleswoman. She's good at being nice to people, buttering them up, getting what she wants, and then she'll stick her high heel through your neck in 5 seconds if it suits her just fine.
I am the leader, and I want something from you. So what do? I kiss ass?
So her tactic, her leadership skills, I think suck.
You guys did not trust in me. You did not believe in me. You did not believe in my leadership.
My team members don't have much experience in business world. I swear if I had a choice, I would fire everyone. And I would work all by myself.
You are a bad girl, Moshe.
I don't give a shit who likes to work with me or not.
Pick on her.
I'm going to screw everybody to go to the end.
Oh, it's about you winning.
It's about me winning, Jeff.
When Steve gets an idea in his mind, that's it. He's not doing anything else. That's it. He's fixed, he's focused, and he's gonna do it anyway.
Steven's a character, all right. He's a nice guy, very creative, but he just goes on and on. He just doesn't know when to stop.
As far as my team members stopping me getting on with what I want to do, it's happened nearly every single task. The more that I push for my idea to go through, the more my idea is refused.
Steve's just on his own planet sometimes.
Steve is a creative genius. He comes out with the most amazing ideas that no one else would think of. Sometimes they're practical, sometimes they're not practical, but it's always good to hear what he has to say.
Look, Steve's a very formidable design challenge. He's very creative. The thing that Steve lacks is control, and I'm hoping that he's out of control.
Steve is Steve. He's got a very strong character. He's very visionary, so when he has an image in mind, he likes to see that come to fruition.
The thing is with Steve, he's kind of verging on genius stroke total chaos.
Good morning, everyone. To make it this far means you are a survivor. All of you have impressed me so far, but it's not over yet. One of you will win the $1 million. You have the business plan in your hand. You have to go and find people who believe in your business plan and show me a level of interest from a potential investor. You have till end of the day, and one of you will be going home. Impress me again.
I'm so happy to be doing this mission. This is the last part of my business plan. And I'm happy to be working by myself because I will be fast, efficient, and thorough without being bothered by others.
When we got our mission, I was very excited because I have a greater network compared to Steve and Richard. And I was 100% sure I can find a high-profile investor. So as soon as I got into the car, I opened my phone book and I decided to look for the high-profile investors to see which one of them will be able to help me. Is this Ashraf?
Yes.
Ashraf, hi, this is Mojib. Today I have a mission to find an investor to invest in my business plan. Like, you know, just a potential investor with a strong profile to...
Please send my email address.
Okay, can I SMS you instead of sending an email?
Yes.
I will just SMS you, and if you would be able to respond to me right away, it would be great, because I don't have much time.
The first thing I decided to do was contact someone who I believed would be able to bring this massive project to fruition. Could I have the telephone number for the Royal Group, please?
Royal Group?
Yeah. Specifically, PAL.
Thank you for calling. The number that you have requested is 026. Thank you for calling in, Isolat.
Hello, is this PAL, part of the Royal Group?
No, wrong number.
The Royal Group, please, in Abu Dhabi.
I don't have them.
You don't have a telephone number for the Royal Group at all?
No.
I need a favour from you. I need to get the address and telephone number for the Royal Group, specifically, if possible, the top guy.
No worries. I'll get back to you shortly, mate.
Thanks very much, Omar. Thank you.
I'm going to call Ingrid Naranjo, who is a Donald Trump connection here. I will call you back in 30 minutes, but I have to ask you a critical question.
Yes.
Are you helping Moje too?
Ingrid, good morning. This is Moje. How are you?
I'm helping Moje. How are you?
Good. Sorry to bother you, but I need a favor to ask. She said she has to look for an investor for me, and she wanted half an hour to come up with a name and think of, like, who would be able to help. So before 6 o'clock, I have to pitch my business plan to them and convince them, like, my business idea is a great idea. It's going to bring a good revenue for them. And just get a letter showing they're willing to invest in my idea. And I called her back, but unfortunately, she was not able to help me because of the limited time we had in hand.
Hi, Omar.
I'm going to number for you for Mr. Bashar. And the number for Mr.
02-66. Great. Thank you very much indeed. I'm hoping to set up a meeting with Bashar as soon as possible.
I'm sorry, sir. You have an appointment with Mr. Bashar?
I don't have an appointment today, but I urgently want to set up a meeting with Sheikh Tanun. And I need to do it within the next 4 or 5 hours. So I'm hoping that Bashar is going to help me and introduce me to the Sheikh.
8 hours difference. So by the time it's 6 p.m. here, it's 10 o'clock in the morning in New York.
Right.
Ingrid called me back. And we discussed having Donald sponsor or invest in my company, but it wasn't going to happen. I immediately started looking at my business cards to figure out who I could get to invest in my business, other than Donald. I felt I had to have 2 or 3 or 4 possibilities going at one time.
May I speak to Joe, please? Hi, Joe. This is Richard Best. I'm an architect, and I met you this past weekend in your office. I called you because you're an architect and you're a CEO and you are the kind of, you're in the kind of position I want to be in eventually.
I wondered if it'd be possible to set an appointment this afternoon as soon as possible with Sheikh Tanun. Could you put me through to Sophia, please?
Okay, she's in the meeting.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, Joe, thank you very, very much.
I decided to go to a coffee shop to settle in and start calling my contacts to find the right person. Harold.
Hi.
Hi, this is Moje. I called so many of my contacts, but the problem I was facing was many of them were in the meetings or out of country, so which it made it very difficult, and I had to just call and call and call to find the right person.
I realized I still hadn't got a meeting set up, so I went through my address book, I phoned up some other investors I knew that would be interested, and pursued those as well.
Steve, unfortunately, I'm leaving.
The customer you are trying to reach is temporarily unavailable.
You've got absolutely no time,
mate. All right, it's
really kind of busy day today.
Is your partner around today?
That was probably a no. I think I've exhausted all my contacts now.
We're sitting right in front of the Abu Dhabi Investment Authority, and I didn't know if they would support a private venture, but I thought, what the heck, they're here, I'm here, I'll give them a call.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. Mark Dhabi is not available. Please call at the tone, please record your message.
I've been trying to get hold of Sophia quite urgently. I had difficulties getting hold of the key person at the Royal Group at such short notice.
Hey, thank you very much indeed. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'd met another investor who was very, very keen on my project, a guy called Holger from Falcon Advisory, and I gave him a call to set up a meeting.
Can you possibly come to Dubai? Or is that difficult?
No, it's not a problem. I can come to Dubai.
Give me about 45 minutes. I'll ring you back, Stephen, OK?
All right.
Hi, Abe.
Good, how about you?
I'm still calling people and no luck.
I contacted one of my good friends, Mr. Ibrahim Turani. He referred me to Mr. Talal, the director of Cycle One. They own a capital funding firm. Mr. Talal, hi. My name is Moje, and I've been referred to you by Abe Turani. How are you? Sorry?
Ibrahim Turani.
Oh, hi,
right,
yes.
How are you doing?
Yeah. Okay, I have a meeting at 8:30, so I can...
It will only take 15 minutes, not more than 15 minutes.
Mr. Talal was very busy and he was in Dubai, so I convinced him to go meet him in Dubai to present my business idea to him. And because he was busy and he had to attend a lot of meetings, he wanted me to email him my business plan and my PowerPoint presentation so he can review it.
I'm the new Hydra executive, I know that.
I wanted to go to the mall and get something to eat and drink. As luck would have it, as soon as I get there, got in contact with Mr. Kenny of First Gulf Bank, and we agreed to have a meeting and go over my plan and see what they could do in terms of a loan.
On my way to Dubai, I got really nervous because we hit the traffic. It was a very bad traffic. It was an accident, and I was kind of nervous because I knew I'm not going to make it on time.
Are we going to be in traffic all day?
I'm still trying to get hold of Sophia. Oh, she's still in a meeting, is she?
Yeah.
Still in a meeting? That's a long meeting. At this point, I had a big decision to make, whether to stick around for a phone call from the Royal Group or go straight to Dubai. I still didn't have an appointment with Holger.